So far, I've only kind of looked at grayscale images. Let's step back and now actually go back to color images. So this is the original color image, the mandrel image that we've looked at before. What we want to do now is start thinking about is what makes this a color image? Well, basically what we need to now start thinking about is what is a red channel, what is a green channel, and a blue channel. In essence, I'm going to claim this image is actually divided into three different color channels. So now I'm going to slowly show you the three different channels, starting with the blue channel. Of course, each color image has three channels with their own intensities. This is the blue channel. If you notice here, the regions in this image which has a lot more blue is, of course, more white because that's where the maximum intensity is. In the green case, if you notice, these parts have a lot more white colors. And in the case of red channel, this part, of course, is the brightest. So in essence, these are the three different channels, and these merge together, blended together, create our color image. So this now makes us want to add one aspect addition to the resolution of the image. That is, we have a width, we have a height, and of course, we have a number of channels. So in essence, if this was a 512 by 512 image, we would also have three channels, and therefore, actually, our resolution would be 512 by 1212 times 3. And following from that, each pixel, therefore, has three intensities. Each and every pixel in this color image has a red value, a green value, and a blue value. And a composite of this gives us a color image. Now, recall from last time that each grayscale image is basically represented by a range of gray values from 0 to 255. That is also true for each and every one of the color channels. 0 to 255. And remembering that basically we said that we need an 8-bit image to be able to get a range from 0 to 255 because that's what we needed. Well, now if I wanted to have three of them, basically you can imagine the range is going to be 24 bits to be able to get a much bigger range than we have right now. And that's what basically we mean by an 8-bit grayscale image or a 24-bit color image.